Okay,
Here we go. We're
what is
good.
it? I tell Aiden, tell him the request.
No, he's here with me in person.
Yeah, what's up? I'm here. I'm right here. What? He's in space. I don't know what the combo's been going on, but
well, it's been interesting.
Fuck Jake Paul.
Hey, bro, come
who
on.
Who said
bro.
That shit?
Bro, what the heck, bro?
Nah, actually, who said that for real? Which bro. British fuck said that?
I said it, so what?
Yo, Idris, suck my dick, bitch. Fuck you.
Suck my dick, you prick.
I'll spit on your dad. Fuck you.
Not Jake Paul out.
I don't give a fuck.
Guess I'll not Jake Paul out.
Yo, suck my dick, bitch. Bro, fuck stop. You. You're not gonna talk my man like that, bitch.
Yo, bro, stop.
Idris, suck my dick, bitch. Fuck you. I said it and I mean it. Oh, God. You're a bitch. Jake Paul will knock you the fuck out. I
shut the fuck up. Case I'm not.
Oh,
case
you got
case
me.
Case I'm not.
Yeah,
no,
I'm
out.
Even gonna talk shit. You don't know who that is or no?
I don't know who he is.
Yeah,
exactly.
Jake, don't even mind that motherfucker.
All right. That was Ryan that told you that.
Yeah, put that kid on mute.
Yeah,
I'm here to talk to Ryan.
Yeah, yep, exactly.
All right, Jake.
Well, shut the fuck up, you pricks.
Bro, hey, get him out of here, bro. Who is this guy? Whose man is this?
Bro, can we mute him? Come on, bro.
It's always the British people always doing the most.
Shut up, man. Am I wrong, Jake? Pulled out. And Ryan, you could shut up as well.
Oh, Idris, I'm not even trying to fight with you, bro.
Oh, I figured it out.
You muted him.
I muted him. I figured it out. Bro, oh, because you're the host. I figured out how to mute him. I don't even know who the fuck. Idris Virgin. What is this?
What is this? Who the fuck is? I don't know. Chat, the only of you guys know who the fuck that is? I don't know who that is. All right, anyways, Ryan, I saw you, you know, you were speaking on something, and I wanted to include Jake in a way. I know you guys were.
So here's the thing.
Have you guys spoken before?
Here, let me clarify things. Everybody thinks like I was actually trying to beef with Drake. Me and Jake have a great relationship. I literally told him God loves you, Jesus loves you. And I literally told him before I was going to start the beef, like, bro, like, let's do a fight, bro. It would break pay-per-view records. Literally, this was all just me just trying to get a super fight going with Jake. And I think that I did it, you know, I respectfully told him beforehand. And I don't know why he took it like it was serious.
Oh, I never took anything serious. I'm on the same page with you. I think it'd be crazy for us to fight, but I also have a ton of mutual respect and love for you and being friends before right. any of this boxing or social media shit. But we can also like make it fun and have a blast right. and make a big fight pop off. I'm not yeah, against right. any of that. And the one thing it does come down to though yep. is. I think you can beat me,
right.
and I don't know if you're prepared for me to be the one to beat you. So that's where right. that's where it got like okay, like because even when you were texting me, you were like, "But bro, like don't worry, I won't hurt you though, bro." And I was like, "All right, but like yeah. I feel the same way. Like I'll we don't need to worry about that. And if we're gonna fight, let's yeah. fucking fight."
Yeah, no, 100%. I already told you I'm going to your weight class. I'll gain the weight. And, I mean, bro, you're facing Mike Tyson. Like, let's be real. Like, don't, you can't even, like, you can't even try to even say what I'm saying is out of line. Because, bro, you're literally fighting Mike Tyson, dog. Like, what the fuck? Like, bro, I'm actually worried for you, bro. No cap, I am. Is that fair?
And honestly, I'm worried for you with Devin. Like,
my God, bro. Devin has pillow hands. You know that.
Not at 140.
Bro, literally, he dropped fucking Regis and didn't do shit. Bro, you have a better killer instinct and fucking stronger than Devin, bro. The fuck am I worried about Devin, bro? The fuck?
I mean, you know? But at the end of the day, regardless of power, that's not his best attribute necessarily.
Just said he had power at 140, dog.
I still think he does. Yeah, I'm not saying that's his best asset. His best asset right. is his technique and skills pay the bills in this shit.
Right.
And he's got the best jab probably in boxing right now. So
when
like,
I out jab him and I out beat him, what are you gonna say then? I just want to know what would be your first statement when I knock him out. Just I just want to know.
I would be what? Like. I would just be like, well, shit, I was wrong, but I'm not afraid.
But can we agree on the tweet, though, that you're going to put out right when I knock him out?
I'm not afraid to be wrong. Like,
me either. What? But I just want to know what tweet can you put out right when I knock him out? What will you say? Can we agree to something?
I'll
agree on what I will tweet if I lose.
Okay, I would tweet like respect. I was wrong.
No, it got to be something better.
Oh, something you want some like funny shit, like some
crazy like shit? Just like let's get creative with it.
All right.
Ryan Garcia is the greatest of all time. And yeah, he can beat my ass and everyone else's ass. Let's not fuck with him no more. If you say that, okay. I'll poop.
Okay, and I'll put you as my profile picture.
Oh, shit.
But then you have to do the same. Okay. If you lose to Devin, you have to say, Jake, Jake, I was wrong. You're my profile picture now.
Okay, all right. I agree, bro. I'll do it for sure.
Okay, well, we can agree on that, but bro, are you training? Because it seems like there's all this crazy shit going on in your life. Like, are you training and focused?
Bro, I'll send you some clips of me sparring and training, and you tell me how I'm looking. That's all I'll say.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just thought it was weird how you still were like agreeing to drink on like Wednesdays and Sundays. Leading up to the fight. Yeah,
bro.
With some wine.
I used to do it all the time, bro, and nothing ever happened to me. Literally, the times I didn't drink is the times that like wasn't my favorite fights. But that's just me, bro. I like to break like conspiracy theories, or not conspiracy theories, but like people's perception on how to be a fighter. And you know, back in the day, they used to take shots of tequila and hop in the ring and knock a motherfucker out. Like me, bro, I just don't listen to nobody, bro. I'm like, I gotta learn for myself, bro. And then like I practice it when I'm training. Like I'll take a fucking drink and then I fight and I'm like, yo, nothing happened. Who the fuck is lying to me now? Like, they say you can't have sex before a fight. Bro, I fucked the day before my fight with Fonseca and then knocked him out cold. Who's creating these fucking lies, dog? This is, like, some funny shit, bro.
I guess, like, to each their own. I know John Jones would get drunk a week before. But, yeah, it from the outside perspective, it just looks like it's not being, like, taken seriously. I think people are actually worried about the fight not even happening.
Yeah, I know people are worried, bro. And they're doing everything in their power to stop it, like trying to do a mental evaluation. I'm saying, okay, I'll do it if fucking Devin does it. If he takes time off his camp to fucking do a mental evaluation, sure, I'll do it. Another thing, what is your premises for my mental evaluation? I've heard other people say crazier shit. And Mike Tyson has said the most craziest shit when it comes to boxing and whatever. He said, I'll eat your children. Literally, where is his mental evaluation? You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, bro, if they don't provide any real premises on why I should get a mental evaluation, I'm not going to do it.